From the edge of Music City, live from Liberty Hall in the historic Factory at Franklin, Music City Roots is on the air. Tonight, four incredible artists based right here in Music City, an indie songwriter, an artist who's gone big time in his way, a roots pop duo who moved here all the way from New Zealand, and two intense female country singers doing tradition their way. It's going to be an excellent. And we're so glad you've joined us. Now, let me turn things over to the man who is guest hosting for his second week in a row. This is getting to be a habit. Would you please wish happy holidays to Peter Cooper? Hey.
Thank you so much, sir.
Well, you're all dressed up tonight.
I am. I'm all dressed up tonight. It's an important night. I'm happy tonight. This is my last show of the year.
Oh, well,
and
I hadn't thought about that.
It's been a great year, and I've been on the road a lot, and I'm looking forward to hunkering down with my family.
Big Christmas then, huh?
Yeah, having a big Christmas with my son Baker.
Yeah,
and we're gonna have a good time, and I want to sing a song about the season that boy, it feels like it was written for me. It wasn't. John Bird wrote it for himself, but it kind of fits my mood tonight.
Well, I'm anxious to hear.
We'll do this for you right now. This is called Silent Night, but it's not the Silent Night that y'all are thinking about. After all the nights and noise from the boys in the band, after all the loneliness from a month of one-night stands, it's good to settle down in a place where I don't have to fuss or fight. It's good to find myself at home with only a silent night. Silent night sets my mind at ease, relieves me of the squeeze, doing what I do. Silent night, no voices in my head, just peace on earth instead, and a silent night. This time of year takes me back to when I was a child, singing carols with little brother just to make our mama smile. Standing on the front seat, holding on with all our might. She drove us home for Christmas, and we sang Silent Night. Silent Night sets my mind at ease, relieves me of the squeeze of doing what I do. Silent Night, no voices in my head, peace on earth instead, and a silent night. The time and place are gone now, never to return, but the memory still finds me, the memory still burns. Maybe gliding down the road on a hot summer day so bright, heading for the next show and humming Silent Night. Silent Night sets my mind at ease, relieves me of the squeeze of doing what I do. Silent Night, no voices in my head, peace on earth instead, and a silent night. Just peace on earth instead, and a silent night. Just peace on earth instead, and a silent night.
Wow.
song written by my buddy John Bird, Keith.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
He's a great writer. That is good stuff. That song kind of centers me. Hello and welcome, folks, to Music City Roots live from the factory. I'm happy you're here. It's great to be back. This is our penultimate show of the year.
I wondered how to pronounce that.
Penultimate.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. If you say penultimate, people think you're an idiot. Well, penultimate doesn't mean the best show necessarily, but the next to the last show. But who knows, this may be the best show of the year. It certainly started out great, didn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, man, guiding us through this time and reading our sponsor messages for you over the airwaves is, he could be uncharitably described as veteran radio announcer. He could be more accurately described as Radio Hall of Famer, ooh, Keith Bilbrey.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, you mentioned your son. I thought about him today. I heard on the news that a certain airline is now going to charge you for bin space above the seats.
Yeah.
You're going to have to buy your son a ticket now. You can't stuff him in the bin anymore.
I know. I'm upset about that. Yeah. Yeah. I really like stuffing him in the bin. We're going to Pensacola in a couple weeks.
Well, he enjoyed it, too.
I was looking forward to stuffing him in that bin.
And, you can do it. You just have to pay for the privilege. It's $25. You can.
Yeah.
You
know. Yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah, I can do that.
Cheaper
than a ticket. I can go 25. Heck, you know, I'm getting paid $35 tonight, so I can do that. Over in the chat room there, waiting with the Blackstone Brewery lineup and more, is our interview guy. Y'all, please welcome Craig Havockhurst.
Hey, everybody. Nice to see you, Ryan. Thanks for coming out on a chilly, early winter night and being with us from Music City Roots. Yes, I do have a lineup in a second. I want to say hello to some guests we have in the audience, or rather some groups, because we love to have groups come and visit us. There's the folks from Epsilon out there. There they are up there.
Epsilon.
Right there between Gamma and Theta in the alphabet, I think, right? And is Empower MX down in the hall and down the floor.
Yeah.
Woo! Good. Well, see, now you've been heard on the radio. You've just made your debut on FM radio. Good to hear you. Good to have you here with us. And everyone is always welcome on Wednesday nights. We do have two more shows here and then a 3-week break where we will focus on Roots Radio WMOT and making some great stuff happen there. Enjoyed your morning shows, Keith, so
thank
much.
You.
9 o'clock in the morning, you can hear
I
Keith.
I enjoy doing it.
And I think on Tuesday I get to sub for you.
Yeah.
Choose some music I want to hear. We also say thanks this week or this time of every show to Soulshine Pizza because they feed the crew every day. They've just opened up an outlet right down here in Franklin at Berry Farms, and that's exciting for the folks of Franklin and anybody that's hung out at Soulshine Pizza in Midtown Nashville knows that they do a great job with the food and the live music, and that's what we try to do here. We also bring it to you with some good beer from Blackstone Brewery, Nashville's oldest craft beer brewery. They've got a new tasting room, tap room at 2312 Clifton Avenue in North Nashville, if you haven't checked that out. And they must be getting close to opening that new, reopening their big restaurant on West End because they've been doing some renovations and can't wait to go see what they've done. Anyway, the lineup tonight features a fellow who has had a robust 10-plus year career as an independent artist, sold a lot of records, filled a lot of rooms, and moved from New York to Nashville a couple of years ago. He is Ron Pope.
Yeah.
Make him welcome. The Pope is in the house. Phenomenal country singer, somebody who was so affectionate about in East Nashville, one of the signature artists of that scene, but making a lot of national noise and getting on a lot of national lists, especially this week with her new album, as she is regarded as one of the finest artists of the year. Kelsey Wilden is here today to play some serious country music. And going to be on this stage for the first time, but we had them at Music City Roots at Mont Eagle a year and a half ago, and we were just mesmerized by them. A wonderful couple who moved all the way from New Zealand a few years ago to be part of the Nashville scene. The Tattletale Saints are here, so make them welcome, too. That's all I got. The Butler Center Stage is ready to bring on the next artist.
Well, yeah, we are. We're ready. We'd like to hear some great music, right? Yeah. Folks, up now is an artist who struck out on the open road just to see what she could see and to take it all in, and her adventures were always paired with music making. So the road led to Nashville, which is the place where the music makers come, and to a musical home at Hi-Lo Records. Her new album, Love is an Outlaw, is just great. Folks, we are so pleased to welcome to our stage, inexplicably for the very first time, Rory Carroll.
Here's a song called Black Dog. First time. Well, I wrote this song about summertime in Nashville, and Nashville is a very shiny town. Lots of sequins and stuff like that, right? Pressure, ever since I got here, when I first got here, the one thing I noticed was that from all the hippie towns that I had lived in, there's not really a lot of pressure in the music industry. But when I came here, I started getting nervous and stuff. And I was like, oh, that kind of makes sense, because, like, pressure makes diamonds. You know, like, the whole Nashville. And I was also like, well, pressure also makes alcoholics. And that's what this song is about. All right, it's called a song called Summer in This Town.
I said some things that I didn't really mean to say. Thank you.
Well, here's a song about going over to that person's house that you know you shouldn't go over to. I grew up in Chicago. I don't know if anyone... Yeah, so I grew up in Chicago, and in Chicago, we have a train system that all have different colors. It's like the blue line and the yellow line and the brown line and stuff like that. And I wrote this song on my way to someone that I probably shouldn't have gone over to very late at night. So that's what this is about. It's called 142 Night Train.
Help.
All right. Like Peter had said, I've kind of been all over this country playing songs wherever I can, and I happened to be riding freight trains for a little bit, and I wrote this song in a train yard in Philadelphia. It was at a church in Philadelphia, from close to the train yard, and I wrote this song there. It's called Mary. All right, that one was a little intense. Thanks for sticking with it. So, like I said, I'm from Chicago, you know. But when I first moved here, I lived at Roberts, like a lot of people do. I found that that was my favorite place, and I figured that I had to write a country song. So I did, and this is a song called I'm Low. It's a my own style country song. It's a little dirty. If you want it so bad, let it go through you. Release if you can, or it will consume you. I know. Well, I drive by your house. I hope you're not home. So much Music City Roots for having us. This is the title track of my new record called Love is an Outlaw. I do say that love is a tramp, and I don't mean it in the way that you'd think. I mean that love is a tramp in the sense that you gotta find ways to always bring love back. You know, it'll wander away if you let it. So when I say that, don't be offended. Or be offended, actually. That's okay, too. There's probably some other stuff that will offend you in this song. So here we go. It's called Love is an Outlaw. Love is an outlaw. Love is a tramp. Love is as aimless as a renegade breaks every rule you have. I think I'm in love. Baby, we're screwed. You're looking at me like a goddamn puppy dog begging for some food. I hope it lasts with you.
tell you mine. We got some trucker speed, a little weed, and all day long to drive somewhere in Texas. Somebody told me he lost his ego in a parking lot on too much LSD. And then a laugh with you, had you. And then we pass on through the blues. And when the light falls on the interstate, your heavy eyes in a different place, your hand in mine 500 miles away. I hope love stays. But love is an outlaw. Love is a tramp. Love is as aimless as a renegade. Breaks every rule you have. It doesn't keep quiet. It don't know how to act. It is as awkward as a teenage boy who just came in his pants. I hope it
so much. This is Matt Rowland over here on the keys. Best hands in Nashville right there. We got Herschel Van Dyke on the drums back here. Steve Daly over here on the guitar. I'm Rory Carroll. Thank you guys so much. Thank you, Music City Roots.
Hey everybody, that was Rory Carroll and her fine, fine band. How about that? Well, if you, Keith Bilbrey, if you know, that's all right. If you like, you know, melody and specificity of language and you know, things like that, and you know, taste and texture. If you don't like that stuff, that was really a horrible set.
I liked it. I liked it a lot.
I did too. I think she's kind of special.
Yeah. I like that Gretsch guitar she was playing too. Sweet. What year is that? You know? Is that an old one or a new one? Or? It's a new one. Okay.
It's a new one.
That's okay. New ones are good too. I tell you, did you get any of that apple pie tonight from
I got Buckets? All the apple pie tonight.
Oh, man. That was so good.
Yeah, it's like pie made with apples, Keith. How can it not be good?
I know, and it's from Puckett's, and Puckett's does a
from
great
Puckett's.
Job of feeding this bunch.
Yeah.
This is a picky bunch. Well, you can please us. The chicken and dumplings, well, excellent.
The crowd may be a picky bunch. The musicians will eat most anything.
Most anything, yeah.
But in this case, you got apple pie from Puckett's.
That's right.
You know, you got some good pie on your hands.
That was good stuff. It's in my belly now, just doing me good. Well, you know, in addition to Puckett's, you don't buy a diamond every day. Was that a segue or what? But
yeah,
when
that
special time comes, just remember, you've got a good friend in the diamond business who just happens to have a product on the cutting edge of the diamond industry. Hello to our road warrior friend. Is he out here tonight? I haven't seen him. Bob Forster, he's out on the road, I guess, out visiting with Star 129 dealers all around the country. He's the Star 129 CEO. Very special fella. We think he's secretly ramping up for a presidential run maybe in 2020. Hey, could happen. Go to the web at star129.com to learn why and how the Star 129 was created to literally outshine ordinary diamonds. Take a look at those before and after photos of diamonds that were recut into Star 129. Absolutely stunning. Now, here in Nashville, the Star 129 is available exclusively over at Bob's Place, Forster's Diamond Outlet. If you're in the Hickory Hollow neighborhood, stop by and see a live comparison. You absolutely won't believe your eyes. Now, if you're not in Nashville, you can find a list of Star 129 dealers all around the country at star129.com. Check it out. Now, here's a fellow who shines in his own light, Craig Havoc-Hurst, over in the chat
Keith
room.
Keith Bilbrey. Hey, everybody. Folks, Megan, welcome. We, as a guy who loves to play live rock and roll, live soul music, and a great songwriter, long time independent career, Mr. Ron Pope is here. He's going to entertain you later. Let's get to know him a little bit. Good to meet you tonight.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. You said you've been in Nashville a couple of years now, right?
Yeah. Moved here about 2 years ago.
Okay. Well, we'll start at the beginning and move you toward that. Atlanta area you grew up. Is that right?
Yep. That's where I grew up.
And what did the living in the South mean to you? Is sort of suburban Atlanta. So, mm-hmm. And it's Marietta, Georgia, as I understood it.
That's where I'm from. That's true.
And did you soak in music directly from the immediate area? Or were you more like on the radio listening into the world?
Well, I think... you know, growing up in the South, I guess you're always kind of mindful of the fact that all of the American music that there is based on, if it doesn't come from there, it's based on something that comes from there. Yeah. So whether you're listening to something that's derivative of things that come before it, like the Allman Brothers, or you're getting to, you know, old Appalachian folk music or whatever, church music, whatever it is, it all comes from there. You know, yeah. Bob Dylan's stealing from there just like all the rest of us, so... Yeah. So that is something I was mindful of.
When did that consciousness begin to kind of dawn on you? Certain people are not going to get that ever, but be a young kid and have to start to know that is rare.
Well, I guess like when I started to learn, like I got to Steve Cropper through Hendrix. Like you learn Little Wing, and then people say, oh, you know, he's doing all those Cropper things, and you're like, oh, who's that now? Mm-hmm. And then you find out that that's a guy playing with Otis Redding. You're like, oh. Yeah. And then, you know, everything runs together. And so I guess, like, just as a kid when I started to play guitar, it all kind of started to come together for me in that way.
What kind of guitars did you take the lessons at the store? Or did you have somebody showing you what went on?
Well, my stepdad started to teach me first. That didn't go so well because nobody wants to listen to their dad. So he started to teach me, and he really liked metal. And I didn't take to that so well either. And so I took lessons and I learned, you know, practice. It was a lot of like hours on my own in my room listening to records and learning from recordings, you know. Like I got Albert King's Greatest Hits and I learned the seven licks and I played them over and over again. And so all
nicely
that.
Nicely said. So guitar is, do you feel like playing? It looks from seeing what I read about you that guitar is a very important part of your musical soul and part of your show and part of your identity.
I think so. I mean, it's nice to have a trade. You know, the music industry is a place where there's ups and there's downs and you're bust and you're flush and there, you know, there's times where people like you and there's times where people, you know, aren't so nice to you. And having the guitar to go back to, having that thing where you can devote yourself to it and you can always get more out of it. That's a nice thing because it's centering, I guess.
Oh, well, you know? So and you have described yourself as somebody that's tried to stay independent, pursue an independent career, kind of the quintessential 21st century model indie career. And I'm curious what you've learned about that, what the parts were that you feel like you figured out early on, and if I stick to that plan, it'll pay rewards.
Well, I think you know, first of all, I would say as you find the right partners in any business, if you find the right people, then you work with them. If you wanted to open a pizzeria and I wanted to open a pizzeria, we could go into business together. But if you wanted to sell tires and I wanted to open a pizzeria, we probably shouldn't go into business together. And so I think it's the same in the music business. If you find like-minded people that want to work with you and that their goals jive with your goals, then it makes sense to work together. So it's just a question of finding the right partners and otherwise being willing to do work yourself. Like, that's the democratization of the music industry, you know, in the digital era. Like, that's a really incredible part of it, is that you can do so much for yourself and spread your music all over the world without anybody's assistance if you don't find those partners.
Right. Yeah, so you had an internet, would you say you had sort of an internet hit early on, that you got a little blow up that got you some attention early on just from something you totally put on there anonymously?
I put it on the, you know, I put up some music on the internet, and I started reaching out to fans and, you know, people that were fans of other bands, trying to find people that liked it. And, yeah, you know, one fan became four, and four became 12, and it just kind of rolled along exponentially and started kind of a global grassroots movement. And that spread my music around.
The Ron Pope movement. You spent how many years in New York City?
14.
Okay. And what do you think you learned about the music there, and how, what was that environment like to do what you do?
Well, there's a lot of different kinds of music that get made in New York. You know, there's people making rootsy music, you know, and there's people making electronic music and dance music. It's just like kind of like in East Nashville, where you go into a place and the person who makes coffee is in a band, and the person who cuts hair is in a band, and the person who drives a car is in a band, and his chef is in the band. And so there's lots of different people making all sorts of different music. So I didn't stumble upon New York City at a time where it was like one thing was happening. So that was exciting everybody I met that was making music was making different music, which is what I find here, and that's what I love so much about this city.
And what kind of places did you feel like to play live brought out the best in you and the band that you wanted to put together? What kind of dynamics were you looking for?
When I first got to New York, anywhere where they would put a microphone in front of me, really, you know, the first couple of years, I played in, you know, bars and cafes, and I played in the subway. I didn't have a microphone. So I played in the subway for a few years.
Sounds good, though.
Yeah, sounds great in there. So.
Yeah. Made it happen. And welcome to Nashville, a little belatedly. Mm-hmm. And everything ready to go over there, by the way, guys? Feeling? You want another second? No, they're ready to go. Okay, we're getting thumbs up. And so there's the new record is called Ron Pope and the Nighthawks, and we'll be hearing hopefully some material from that later on. And nice to meet you and have you here.
Thanks for having me.
We'll have you on stage in a little bit. Ron Pope, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks, mate. Snap that right in there. And over on stage left, Miss Allie Sutton, looking lovely tonight. How are you, Allie?
I'm doing fantastic. I don't know about you guys, but I know exactly what I want for Christmas. Santa's got the goods, Christmas in a can, hot Vienna chili, Santa, you're my man. Santa, you're so good, open up a can, hot Vienna chili, Santa, you're my man. Oh, Santa, you're my man, that's right. Santa, you're my man. Merry Christmas, everyone. Mark, tell us who we're listening to.
You are listening to Music City Roots on Roots Radio 89.5 FM, Murfreesboro, the pride of Middle Tennessee State University. 100,000 watts of pure Americana.
That's right. Now back to the show with Mr. Peter Cooper.
Thank you so much. Boy, it is the pride of Middle Tennessee. And that Vietti Chili song exemplifies the pride that we all feel in Murfreesboro and in Chili, you know, in our hearts and souls. Folks, the prize for the band that came the farthest to be here with us tonight goes to these folks. Truth be told, they haven't come that far recently. They've been in Nashville for a few years. But New Zealand is their home. It's a horrible place. Keith Urban managed to escape early on in his life from New Zealand. But they were able to get out of there, and we are lucky to have them. Great songs, great sound, brand new album. Folks, please welcome the Tattletale Saints.
If I had a dollar for every time I've cried, every time I've hung my head or searched for reasons why, I could buy myself an island under a distant set of stars, and build it up, start again, and ring you from my heart. But we heal slow, a penny at a time, a piggy bank with little pieces of your heart inside. It's never easy, it goes at its own pace. So if I had a dollar, I bet I'd feel just the same. If I were a rich man with my new life in the sun, eating shrimp and drinking Beaujolais, feeling free and having fun. The daylight hours pass quickly. It's when I blinds, but what I thought was in my past moves from shadows to the light. 'Cause we heal slow, a penny at a time, a piggy bank with little pieces of your heart inside. It's never
very much indeed. We haven't really traveled that far to get here. It was like a 25-minute drive or something, but we appreciate the thought that we are the band that has worked the hardest to get here. All right, we're going to play a road song. It's a song called Sonoma County Wine.
I've been going since the daybreak over the Sierras and the Salt Lakes. I had a little trouble with the engine round about the Arizona line. I found a little motel as the sun was going down. I wasn't looking my best, I needed some rest, so I never expected what I found.
He was dirty as a dish rag, dressed up like a yard sale. Wandered into my office like an old dog sniffing for some food. But he spoke in a soft voice, so can I get a room, miss? Put his hands on the counter, smiled and looked me in the eye.
So I called up the front desk, asked her how she was doing. Said, are you getting off soon? You wanna come out tonight? She was a little hesitated, but I could tell she was thinking. So I said, I got a bag of weed, a fifth of whiskey, and a bottle of Sonoma County wine.
Well, it hadn't been the best week, tired of the tourist and tumbleweed. I was staring up at the clock when I
Guess I'm typically a shy man and didn't get my hopes up high. But she said, meet me by the pool in a half an hour. Talked into the morning, made love until the dawn. She said, I don't know where you're going, but I wish I was coming along. So when I caught up the front desk, asked her how she was doing. Said, are you getting off soon? You wanna come out tonight? She was a little hesitated, but I could tell she was thinking. So I said, I got a bag of weed, a fifth of whiskey, and a bottle of Sonoma County wine. Late in the morning, I turned and she was gone. I gathered my possessions and thought about picking up the phone. But when I got to my car, she was leaning on the hood. And she said, I don't know how you feel about traveling alone, but I think a little company is good. It's when he called up the front desk, asked me how I was doing. Said, are you getting off soon? You wanna come out tonight? I was a little hesitated, but I liked the way he was thinking. When he said, I got a bag of weed, a fifth of whiskey, and a bottle of Sonoma County wine. A bag of weed, a fifth of whiskey, and a bottle of Sonoma County wine.
Great time to introduce, start introducing the band. Josh Kaler on the pedal steel over there is our great, great friend and also produced the most recent album we made. So we got to spend a lot of time in a dark room with Josh and Sai, spending a lot of time with guitar pedals and amps and noises. And that solo you just heard is the culmination of all of that time.
That was the most indulgent day that we had in the solo, writing a guitar mini. Let's take him to the bridge. We're going to play a song now called I Did This to Myself, which is going to have some beautiful pedal steel on it.
I did this to myself. I threw it all away. I couldn't stand the distance. I wouldn't last the wait. I wanted to be decent to your ever-patient heart, but I let you go like an employee. Broke our dream apart. If only you had cheated me all those long weeks on the road. If I returned home to find you in his arms, I wouldn't still be stuck here on this carousel of doubt. I wouldn't still be missing you. Many times I'm lonesome, I'm stumbling and lost. But I won't take no pity before I die. big song road. If I returned home to find you as old, I wouldn't still be stuck here on this carousel of doubt. I wouldn't still be missing you. Many times I'm broken by what my haste has caused, but please, brother, don't console me now, for I did this to myself.
Thank you very much. All right, this next song is a good opportunity to introduce my longtime friend, my wonderful bandmate. She has been with me in many different journeys, and we have been together through many different shapes of life, and she is going to take a bass solo in this next song. She is from Auckland, New Zealand. Her name is Vanessa Evelyn McGowan. This is a song called I Don't Sing So Much No More. All right.
I don't sing so much no more. I'm standing in the shower, when I'm hanging my old t-shirts on the line. I don't whistle while I'm working, walking home to the radio, all my old familiar songs. The tune is all but gone, so I listen to the sound of my t-shirts in the wind, and I hear the wash of traffic going by, and I allow myself to think it's your car pulling in, and you're singing from the driveway up the pathway to our door. Then I remember no more. When I'm standing in the shower, when I'm hanging my old t-shirts on the line, I don't whistle while I'm working, I walk home to the radio, all my old familiar songs. The tune is all but gone, so I listen to the sound of my t-shirts in the wind, And I hear the wash of traffic going by. And I lull myself to thinking it's your car pulling in, and you're singing from the driveway up the pathway to our door. And I remember why I don't sing so much no more.
Guys, thank you so much. All right, now last, but most certainly not least, this is a chap who we've known for about a year. We've been living here for about 3 years. We moved here from New Zealand, and we met this guy about a year ago. And he has become a great friend of ours and a great asset in our band. And where is he from? New York? Anyway, I know his name. His name is Matty Algers, and he's a great man. And give it up for Matty Algers on the drums. All right, it's a song called Big City Women. All right. Actually, let me just get a guitar tone tune. All right.
Big city women, pretty as a paycheck, stubborn as the buckle on your shoe. They see every walk of life riding on the subway, so they'll never be impressed by you. Big city women, cool and calculated, got you where they want you to be. I'm laying on that southern charm, but my howdy must be broken, 'cause these city girls just walk all over me. I had a good-hearted woman, name was Isabella, sweetest little thing in Tennessee. Soft hair, green eyes, the color of a melon, couldn't get enough of loving me. But I was fixed to the vision of them slick city girls with their parties and cocktails and cabs. I said, don't cry, Isabella, and she drove me to the station. You'll find yourself a simple countryman. Big city women, pretty as a paycheck, stubborn as the buckle on your shoe. They've seen every walk of life riding on the subway, so they'll never be impressed by you. Big city women, cool and calculated, got you where they want you to be. I'm laying on that southern charm, but my howdy must be broken, 'cause these city girls just walk all over me. Credit card was scraping the bottom, and I knew I was being taken for a ride. So I called Isabella, heard the voice of my angel, said, baby, I'm coming back home. She just laughed in my face and said, don't bother, city boy, this town's a whole lot better with you gone. Oh, big city women, pretty as a paycheck, stubborn as the buckle on your shoe. They've seen every walk of life riding on the subway, so they'll never be impressed by you. Big city women, cool and calculated, got you where they want you to be. I'm laying on that southern charm, but my howdy must be broken, 'cause these city guys just walk all over. I'm laying on that southern charm, but my howdy must be broken, 'cause these city guys just walk all over me. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. We are Telltale Saints. We're very grateful. Have a good one.
Telltale Saints, everybody. All the way from New Zealand. How about that? Man, once it pretty good, somebody says from back there. I think it was more than pretty good, folks. What do you think?
Yeah.
Wow. If you don't think it was more than pretty good, I'll drill a hole in you.
Oh, gosh, turn him loose with the power tools. That's
yeah,
kind of scary.
Yeah, I'm really good with the power. I'm a very handy person, Keith Bilbrey.
Yes.
Yeah, we know this.
Do we know this for sure?
Yeah, I can't tell you the things that I built with this very thing. What I don't know what this is, but it makes me feel powerful.
There you go. Nothing like
it. It's kind of heavy, though. It's sort of... I'm feeling a little drained. If somebody
nothing like a power tool. I just like that suit, man. You look like Clark Kent tonight, don't you? Newspaper reporter, mild-mannered newspaper reporter for the Daily Globe. That would be you.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Good. I pride myself on my mild manner.
There you go. So happy to be live on the air with our new partners at 89.5 WMOT, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Franklin, a service of Middle Tennessee State University's College of Media and Entertainment. You've been down there, haven't you?
I have been down there,
it
and I also
cool
am a
place.
I'm an everyday listener of WMOT,
man.
And I cannot tell you how wonderful it is to have that in my life as I'm driving around. It, you know, you can be in traffic and you would be, you know, frustrated or
level
something.
You right out.
Doesn't happen. It. I hear the dulcet tones of Keith Bilbrey,
and I
feel,
right,
you know,
you
kind
go.
Of enlivened, and I feel a weight lifted.
Weight
from
lifted.
Me.
Oh, I'm glad I'm lifting weights now. The
yeah.
Doctor's been after me
yeah.
to do that for years.
Yeah, and the most important thing, I guess, is that I hear great music.
Yeah.
Some of it coming from people who are my friends.
Uh-huh.
Some of it coming from people who are my heroes.
Yep.
And it is just a wonderful thing to hear that. And it's like nothing else on the radio
that's
dial.
Right.
There's no other major metropolitan Americana station.
Yeah. No punching around. Nothing like that.
Doesn't exist,
right,
man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you heard John and Bill in the morning?
I have heard John
Walker
and Bill in the morning.
And,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't want to talk about that.
There's a hot spot, yeah. These guys are having way too much fun. But we love Middle Tennessee State University, and we've been working together to bring you all the great music from the artists that you've come to know and love, just like Peter Cooper. Matter of fact, I play some Peter Cooper on there every now and then. We're on practically 24/7. Speaking of which, we'd like to thank our sponsors at Acceptance Auto Insurance for not only supporting Music City Roots on our nationwide PBS television series, but now bringing you the Acceptance Auto Insurance Morning Ride. That's what we were talking about with our own John Walker and Bill Edwards. John's not here tonight. He's got to get up early nowadays. So he's on from 6 to 9 a.m. And I come on from 9 till noon. And I got to tell you, these guys are having way too much fun bringing you all the music news and traffic news you need for your morning ride. Acceptance takes pride in delivering auto insurance, even to folks who've had some, let's say, challenges with their auto insurance. More about that later. For now, just remember, you can learn more at acceptance.com. Your terms accepted, just like Craig Havokhurst. He sits you down there,
accepting of
just
anything.
Accepts you and wants to hear your story, right?
Thanks. Folks, her current album is Love is an Outlaw. She did a great job opening the show up tonight. Please welcome Rory Carroll back to the stage. Sounds like you did a lot of traveling after leaving Chicago. Were you a suburban Chicago kid or a city Chicago kid?
Just outside Park Ridge area, so suburban.
Yeah.
Yep.
I went to college there. I love Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
My dad grew up there. It's favorite second city of ours. Oh, it's just
too.
An amazing, amazing place. But from reading your bio, I almost read between the lines, so I have to ask the question. Did you certifiably run away from home, or was it not quite that dramatic?
Not quite that dramatic. My parents are great. I've just always kind of wanted to get away from the suburban, mundane lifestyle that I grew up with. I just never really felt like I belonged there.
Okay.
So
when you lit out for the territories, what was guiding you? Where did you go? And
well, I went to tried college for a little bit, and that didn't last very long for a semester, and then I dropped out, and I went and hiked the Appalachian Trail. when I was 20 years old.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Was that a structured thing, or was that a I'll start and then this is good and I kept going, or what was the plan there?
It was just something that I just had kind of, well, wanted to do for a couple months. When I found out what it was, I was like, I want to do that. And so I figured it out, did some research, and yeah.
How many miles was that?
2,176.
Wow, man. That's fantastic.
My life has never been the same since.
Well, what do you think you took away? What do you think you took away from that experience?
I met a lot of different people from a lot of different backgrounds and culture. And I took away the fact that I can really get away with doing a lot on my back and just being independent and seeing the world that way. It was
traveling light.
Traveling light, you know, meeting all the right people. That's all you need.
How did music figure into that journey and what happened right next?
Well, I started playing guitar around that time, and I actually learned a lot when I was on the trail, actually. I would meet different people along the way, and I had a little backpacking guitar, and people would teach me songs and stuff and chords. So campfire jams, you know, dead songs and stuff like that.
Yeah, what were some of the, you know, kind of either schools of songs that you found you really wanted to learn to get in your head and your hands, or artists that you were trying to kind of emulate a little bit?
At the time, I was listening to a lot of bluegrass music, surprisingly, just because it was kind of that mountain music, and I had met a lot of people from that era or from that area.
Sure, so if you're in the Smoky Mountains and you're going over a Rocky Top, literally, you know.
Oh, yeah, I sang that at karaoke in Gatlinburg, which, yeah. All the people in Gatlinburg, very much in my heart right now.
We will be meeting them in a couple of weeks and seeing what we can do to help them, actually.
Great. Yeah,
we'll talk about that at the end of the show.
Great.
And then Nashville. So what guided you here, and was music somewhat professional at that point for you?
It was somewhat professional. I was a marijuana trafficker. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that on this.
Sinner life story. You should read it online. It's good stuff. She made High Times magazine, folks. I've never done that.
And so that was kind of a big blow, you know, being a felon and everything and living in an RV, which I still live in an RV. But so I kind of just decided that I needed to clean up my life and move to Nashville and do it the right way. And it's been...
So you hung out with Todd Snyder,
which
is
the shortest
way.
Yes, I found Todd Snyder, who picked me up, brushed me off, and threw me on stage all over the country.
So he really did break some opportunities for you. Must have been extraordinary.
He's been the best. He's been a great mentor and great friend of mine. So he's taught me a lot. I feel like I've progressed a lot as an artist since I've been with him.
What has it been like going out in some of those... I mean, he plays in big theaters, and you've got a new bag of songs, and you walk out there. Has that been a cool experience?
It's been crazy. Like, I walked out on the Ryman, and I thought I was jumping off a cliff.
Yeah.
By myself, just at the Ryman, like, oh, no big deal. but yeah, it's been really amazing getting comfortable with audiences and playing by myself. And the stories that I have, I'd never really had done that troubadour thing of telling stories. So it was neat. It was like, I have a lot of stories to tell. I just have to word them right. So.
Well, congratulations on all the success.
Thank you.
The album, Love is an Outlaw, is really terrific and very varied and sonic and rich. You make it here right in town, I'm assuming.
Yeah, with a lot of my friends in an East Nashville studio. So.
Good. The quintessential story just plays out, but great stuff. Rory Carroll, one more time, everybody.
Thank you.
Absolutely love it.
Thank you.
How's the country band on stage looking? Feeling right? Peter Cooper.
Hey, Craig. Yeah, we're doing great up here. We were just talking about the differences between states and commonwealths and having a sincere discussion about that. Folks, it is so great to see this artist on the Roots stage after a 2.5-year absence. Where in the world were you? We're happy to see her because we dearly love country music, and she is making some of the best country music that is being made. With roots in her home, I started to say state, but it's a commonwealth of Kentucky, and the finest traditions of Music City, her acclaimed new album is called I've Got a Way. Please welcome, and this is just going to knock your socks off, so if you've got socks that you're concerned about, hold them close to your person. Please welcome Kelsey Walden.
I can't use it, but it without it, I never had to. Thank you all very much. We're going to keep this short and sweet, so I'm not really going to talk very much. I just wanted to thank you for the heartbreak, all those times the sight of my face I could not bear, those days I couldn't get out of bed. You messed so much with my head that I couldn't see the future that was there. We're all just trying to get better. We're all just trying to do the best that we can. So I just wanted to thank you for the heartbreak, because it brought me to where I am. Can't hold no grudges on life's long journey. Can't live with bitterness or demand. In all the bridges we've crossed and all the friends that we've lost are all a part of so much. That's on my new record. It's great to be here with all these friends tonight, and this is our last show of the year. So thank y'all for being here. This next song we're going to do is a Bill Monroe song we did on my record. I'm traveling down this lonesome road, oh how I hate to go. The wind and storms are raging high and it's awful cold. The kind of love
road. Thanks, y'all. It's a pleasure to be here. I want to introduce my band real quick up here. We got Mr. Mike Khalil on the electric guitar over here. Ross McReynolds on the drums. Alan Newnham on the bass. It's his birthday. And Mr. Brett Resnick on the pedal steel guitar over here. He's been with me for many years. And my name's Kelsey Walden. And this song is about loving yourself in a healthy way. Many people want to run and hide. They want to run from what scares them deep inside. You wouldn't look it in the face, never let it show. I'm about to tell you something that you already know. That when you want it to be, you needed somebody else. But I can be me all by myself. I can be me all by myself. So much.
Kelsey Walden from the Commonwealth of Kentucky. How about them apples? She's just all eat up with good. She's just something else. Man, and what about this band, huh?
Yeah. Good stuff.
The Kelsey Walden Band.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, they're no joke, Keith Bilbrey.
That's steel player. Whoa.
The steel guy? I don't know. I don't know. I'm not sure about him. But but everybody else, I'll tell you, what a rhythm section that was.
There you go.
The steel guy, he had to use two necks in order to accomplish that sound.
That's
so,
right.
You know, it was kind of like, what do you call it, cheating? Yeah,
no.
I think that's what you call it. But I'm hoping that steel hangs around for our jam later on this evening, because we could use it. And actually, he makes pretty good use of those two necks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And the
Keith,
pedals.
You make good use of that golden voice. It's brought you into the Hall of Fame.
Well, it did, and I'm just still amazed at that. But
Well, I'm not amazed. Your dulcet tones, you know, I've recorded you talking.
Keep talking.
About things, and it's what it's the first thing that I listen to in the morning when I wake up and go off to do great things.
Well, you compliment me on my voice. I compliment you on that suit, man. I like that suit.
Well,
I wish I wore a tall suit. I'd get one just like it. Music City Roots receives support for this broadcast from businesses that are leaders in our community, like Nissan North America, makers of the 100% electric, no-gas Nissan Leaf. You folks watching online are seeing our friend Larry Nager show off the roomy interior by packing his upright bass in the back, or you can fit five passengers if you prefer. Every new Nissan Leaf in the United States comes from right here in Tennessee. Vehicle and battery plants in Smyrna and Deckard, and Nissan North America world headquarters right here in Franklin, Tennessee. Nissan's proud to support local music and sports in our community, and we give them a big thanks for supporting Music City Roots. Nissan, Nashville proud. And from Ascend Federal Credit Union, the preferred credit union of MTSU Athletics. Ascend offers convenient online account access, bill payment, and statements with an app to access your accounts on the go. Visit ascendfcu.org to register for e-services from Ascend. Ascend Federal Credit Union, raising possibilities. Ascend is federally insured by the NCUA. Membership is limited. Once again, to the chat room, and Craig Havoc-Hurst, who you got over there?
Yeah, well, we're still basking in the glow of that great country music. One more time for Kelsey Walden, folks. Solid. Yeah, Kentucky's a special musical culture. I looked it up. You're from Ballard County, Kentucky. Give us a little geography about Ballard County.
Well, Ballard is in actually one of the farthest, most western parts of Kentucky. It's in between where the Mississippi and the Ohio come together right there.
Okay.
Yeah.
And a lot of family going back years there? Is that do you have multi-generations in the area?
Yeah, I'm the only one that left.
Really?
Yeah.
how big
I'm
a deal?
I'm the only one left, and I'm here now. But yeah, all my ancestors were all started back in Ballard. So,
how big a deal was that to leave? What, like, did you have to explain yourself to everybody and folks? I'm going to the big. What happened?
Well, I lived in Nashville for about 7 years now, but yeah, I mean it was. I mean, I don't know. I kind of just randomly left. You know, I kind of moved in when I was 19 with a girl I actually barely knew. Totally different part of my life, but. But yeah, I kind of just jetted and knew I had to be here. So,
were you chasing that country music thing? Was that why Nashville? Were you? I'm gonna write songs in Nashville, Tennessee.
Right. No, I just I kind of knew I needed to be here. You know, if I wanted to be taken seriously, and also just if I wanted to learn from anybody or anything, you know, or get better at all. I mean, I really came here to learn. You know. And better my craft. So
something stood out in your bio where you talked about not listening to your heroes and their records, but studying them, like really thinking about how Tammy sang or how George Jones sang and what the record sounded like. Is that a fair way to put it? That you really?
Well, yeah, for sure. I mean, I'm trying to learn all the time, and I think there's also a safe distance you should keep from your heroes. You know, because you don't want to. You know, you can't relive what your heroes did. You just got to be yourself.
But I mean, what guided you? What was, what, how did you approach, you know, getting better at this craft? What was, what steps did you take?
Well, you know, just meeting a bunch of people that were just like me, you know, and learning from that and attending lots of picking parties, going to all the shows I could, and just taking any advice, anything like that that I could. You know, one time Eddie Stubbs told me if I wanted groceries, I had to go to the store, you know. So I went to the store.
That's a metaphor.
I went to the
Folks,
store.
Coming from Eddie Stubbs, that's a metaphor. And your first record was Goldmine. I love that record. Went back and listened to it again recently. It's just a lot of just great, just tunes. I mean, just like really hummable, beautiful. You know, you can get your head around them quick, but wonderful stuff. And what was going on in your life that let you make that first? That is, I assume that's a debut album, right?
Yeah, it was kind of a debut album. You know, that one was just totally kind of no pressure at all, just kind of didn't really know what we were getting into. I just really wanted to make a record, and it all kind of organically happened, really. You know, we recorded it in 2 days. I mean, it seems crazy now. I when I listen to it now, I feel like it's not even me. It's, okay. I mean, I know it's me, yeah. But you know what I mean? So.
did you have to sort of, did a day come when you had to look around and say to somebody, I'm ready to make a record, what do I do now? Like, seek out the help, or did somebody say, you are ready to make a record and come on and let me, you know, start the process in motion? How did that go?
Yeah, well, I've been very lucky to have much support and many friends who have helped me along the way, and really great musicians. And actually my friend and producer, Michael Rennie, he produced that record as well as my new one, helped me do that with the band. And so actually, you know, he really helped me get that whole thing together. And Brett played on it as well.
Yep.
A steel player that was here tonight, so.
And the new one is I've Got a Way. I've Got a Way.
Yes.
And folks are recognizing it. The magazines are starting to put this on their best of the year lists, and congratulations on that. NPR, I think, picked that up. And any thoughts on sort of where you feel like, as that second record came, you felt more in control and more confident about what you're doing?
I did, yeah, I definitely did. I had a really strong vision for it and was very inspired when we were putting it together. And I kind of feel like I knew exactly what I wanted to hear. But, you know, I still think I can do better.
I'm going to be kind of interesting. I never asked an artist this before, but when you're making a record, after you've been touring and you've played rooms here and there, some of them fuller than others, and gotten a sense of what the audience is listening for and what works, and that when you're starting to get in the studio, you must be thinking ahead a little bit. I'm going to have to go back to that place and meet those people again. And this song is now for them. And what are they going to think? And it must be interesting.
Right. Yeah, for sure. It's, you know, I'm always kind of thinking in the back of my mind, you know, what I should do next or what I'm going to do next, or, you know, new ways to be inspired all the time.
Cool.
So.
How widely are you traveling, by the way, when you go out, and how many seasons are you taking away from Nashville and touring?
Well, we actually just got off the road. We were on the road for a little over a week, just recently, got back Monday night. We've been touring pretty heavily since the record came out in August. So.
Uh-huh.
So it's been really, really
been a good time. Been
it's
fun?
Been awesome. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been really great. You know, some of the shows are, you know, pretty raging, and some of them are, you know, we might play to 5 people somewhere, mm-hmm. But you know, we're working, and I feel grateful for it. So.
Right, you got to do it. How's the big band getting set up there, Ryan? You got a thumbs up? Yeah, cool. There's a lot of amplifiers and keyboards on stage. We love seeing you. Good to have you back, Kelsey.
I'm happy
it's
to
a
be
treat.
Here. Yeah.
Kelsey Walden, everybody. Well, they can't have a big old band get introduced without a musical host. That musical host tonight is Peter Cooper. He is center stage.
Hey, Craig Habeckhurst, over there in the chat room. We were just having a heart-to-heart about Doogie Howser over here, and all of us, and you know, and I think I speak for all of y'all, too. We all love Doogie Howser, a great American artist. Hey, we love artists who make a big impression all on their own, and this fella right here takes justifiable pride in his shirt, okay? All right? And in selling recordings and in placing songs on TV with notable TV stars like Doogie Howser, and was selling out venues as an indie artist. His powerful voice and touch with songs is clear as can be on his new self-titled album. Y'all, this is a stunning talent. Please welcome Ron Pope.
Steady taking the road. Mr. Travel, I decided I had someplace to go. You look better in this light to me than ever before. I would apologize, but you don't wanna hear it no more. I didn't resign for a while, but I'm slurring my words. Sticks, stones, rocks, and bullets, ain't nothing that works. I've been down by the corner, just waiting my turn. But the bus ain't even running, this will turn in reverse. I got the bad intentions, but I got the good heart. Yes, I got the wrong directions, so I've been lost from the start. And if you need redemption, you're barking in the wrong backyard. I got the bad intentions and the good heart. Wait a second, I remembered what I wanted to say. No, I lost it, never mind, I'm out of reasons to stay. I'm just to finish up my drink, then I hop on a train. Wait a second, I remembered what I wanted to say. I got the bad intentions, but I got your good heart. Yes, I got the wrong directions, so I've been lost from the start. And if you need redemption, you're barking in the wrong backyard. Yes, I got the bad intentions and the good heart. I got the good heart. Yes, I got the wrong directions, so I've been lost from the start. And if you need redemption, you're barking in the wrong backyard. Yes, I got the bad intentions and the good heart. I got the bad intentions and the good heart.
Thank you. you very much. Y'all are making me warm. rim shot, by the way. If I could. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Working on our timing.
Yeah.
I mostly do this so they'll give me a mic and I can do stand up. That's really like, you know. I'm not funny enough that they would just give me the mic, so I gotta play songs in between. It's like vaudeville. It's kinda like vaudeville.
Oh man. Alright. Okay.
We've been flirting with disaster now, and I don't know if we can turn this one around. Used to spend our days in laughter, but somehow it seems that I can only bring you down. And I know that time isn't at home outside, but if it's too late, no more tears to cry. And I wonder why we never decide to say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Know that you don't like to compromise. You always seem to get your way, but if you take a little of your own advice, love, it seems you'd rather throw it all away. And I know that time isn't at home outside, but if it's too late, no more tears to cry. And I wonder why we never decide to say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. You thought you'd get from me when you're lonely and I'm far away. I bet you miss my company, and I know that time isn't at home outside, but if it's too late, no more tears to cry. And I wonder why we never decide to say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. But if it's too late, no more tears to cry. And I wonder why we never decide to say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
Give it up for Joe Vaughn, huh? Now it's starting to get loose.
Jeff and I are dressed the same. We know. And I'm kind of excited about it, personally.
You got the fancy version. I'm the basic cable. Yours is HBO.
Oh, that is so nice of you to say. Oh,
see?
We're working on this. We're going to get there, y'all. Nah. Because I would love for us to be wearing uniforms. That would be really funny. Like, imagine us all dressed the same, especially Vanessa. Like, that would be my favorite part. I mean, we're kind of dressed the same, to be fair. But imagine if we were really all dressed the same, like, identically. I would enjoy that. I don't know. I like matching outfits. I'm always trying to get my wife to be dressed the same, like, as I am. And she's like, oh, did you just happen to put on a gray T-shirt today? I'm like, no, I saw you in it. And I thought it would be cool, but apparently it's not cool. So, I like matching. I don't know. Whatever. Don't be a cop about it. So, this is a brand new song. Well, I think we're going to play a new song. Yeah, this is a brand new song. And it's about the time in your life when you are old enough to know, but young enough not to give a damn. And so, yeah. This is a song about being young.
It's called Let's Get Stoned.
Started with a spark, then we caught fire. We were moving fast, held up by spare tires. Old enough to know, young enough not to care. I was hungry and lean, too dumb to be scared. I wasn't looking for trouble, but trouble found me. I told you what I wanted, you gave me what I need. A pretty little girl, 3 days from 18. I said, damn, you look good to me. So let's get stoned, turn the radio. Y'all felt good, no one called it love. Your blonde hair falling long, covered up my eyes. Night's just coming on, ain't gotta rush home. Baby, let's get stoned. She was my first everything, oh sweet innocence. Summertime comes, I still think of her now. Long legs wrapped in mine, with the moon coming out. There was thunder in the darkness. We were both aching, restless for the contact. My hands shaking, when she's on my mind. I'm still 17, saying damn, you look good to me. So let's get stoned, turn the radio up. I know it shall feel good. No one would call it love. Your blonde hair falling long, covered up my eyes. Night's just coming on, ain't gotta rush home. Baby, let's get stoned. Y'all felt good, no one wouldn't call it love. Your blonde hair falling long, covered up my eyes. Night's just coming on, ain't gotta rush home. Baby, let's get stoned. Baby, let's get stoned. Baby, let's get stoned.
is here.
Yeah. Yeah. Jeff just said underneath his breath, your fan is here. Yeah. Your singular fan. In the spirit of, I'm not going to say anything mean back to you. In the spirit of friendship, Jeff. In the spirit of friendship, I'm not going to say one hurtful thing to you. I appreciate Music City Roots for having us out. Even Jeff, who obviously I don't like very much. Give it up for Jeff Malinowski, our musical director, by the way. Good man. Wonderful man. Hurtful sometimes, but what are you going to do? We're old friends. It's okay. So we appreciate Music City Roots for having us out. We're having a blast here. This has been a fun day. There's been great music. We saw lots of friends here and met some new friends, and it's been a great day. So thank you for having us. And this will be our last song. And I think the end of the organized portion of the evening. It's going to get dicey from here. Yeah, so this is another new song that I thought we would share with you. This is my father always says, nothing good happens after 2 a.m., but lots of stuff good will happen if you wake up early. And this is a song about why you should go to bed early. So.
Okay. To know if I got more to lose, but I am not sure myself. And if I share another drink with you, well, I don't think that will help. And as the sun comes up, I'll be coming down. Don't think I'm gonna sleep too well. If our time runs out, don't you call my name. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Sunday, but I may be wrong, 'cause I am not keeping count. And when your world is crumbling, I'll be gone long before our fire burns out. And as the sun comes up, I'll be coming down. Don't think I'm gonna sleep too well. She called my name, chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. And as the sun comes up, I'll be coming down. Don't think I'm gonna sleep too well. And if our time runs out, don't you call my name. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Chasing angels, but you end up in hell. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. I'm Ron Pope. We appreciate you.
Ron Pope and band. Holy cow. Keith Bilbrey, it seems we've had an evening of wonderful music that is, unmesswithable.
Unmesswithable.
That's right.
You're just full of great terms tonight.
That is fresh.
Unmesswithable.
I don't think you can mess with it.
I tend to agree.
Have y'all had fun? Yeah. All right.
Are you ready for one more song? We're going to be doing that in a second. Peter, organize your jam.
Well, yeah, we'll organize it. We'll have folks coming out, we'll have lots of organizational kinds of organizing.
I think Ron said it best. It's going to get dicey from here.
Oh, no, it's going to be horrible. Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Well, I heard the song that you chose. It's going to be great. Folks, I get to tell you, because it's just past the hour that you're listening to all this fine music out there on the airwaves of 89.5 WMOT, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Franklin, Roots Radio. Please listen throughout the week as folks like Keith Bilbrey spin great music and share Roots in Americana, the sound of contemporary Nashville, with you. We want to say thanks to all the lineup tonight in the Blackstone Brewery Group, Ron Pope, Kelsey Walden, Tattletale Saints, and Rory Carroll. Let's hear it for all those folks one more time. They're coming to the stage to play a final song for you in the Nashville Jam. Next week, we will be back for one more show for the season. We're going to close things down in a big way with the Buckleys, with Farmer and Adele, a terrific East Nashville country band. Him for Her is coming back to do their twangy thing. They travel the road in their camper, and they throw down, and return of favorites, the Kentucky Headhunters, here for a set on the stage of Music City Roots. That's 1 week from tonight, so get your tickets now. And we broke some news today that's very exciting. Rory was good to mention the strife and difficulty up there in Gatlinburg, Tennessee. They really have been hit very hard, lost lives, lost homes, lost businesses, and we wanted to help out. And we got a call this week from the Gatlinburg Convention Visitors Bureau and our friends at Old Smoky Moonshine and Yeehaw Brewing, and we are throwing together a pretty big event on December 17th, Saturday, starting in the late morning or around noon, a free all-day event called Gatlinburg Mountain Tough, a benefit for the Sevier County Community Fund. All the proceeds that we raise in a telethon-style phone bank and online and buckets there on site, and hopefully the running the week up. We're going to have a blog tomorrow with all the details. Saturday, December 17th, Zach Brown Band is committed. Sam Bush will be there. Jason D. Williams will be there. Derek St. Holmes, Jim Lauderdale, our good buddy. And we'll be flying the flag for Music City Roots and sharing and learning what we can about the situation. I know it's going to be different being there and seeing on the ground. It's something else. But we want to do what we can, and we'll be there on December 17th. So come on up and be with us. And the folks from Gatlinburg want you to know that they are open for business. They want folks to come up, hang out, spend money, be part of the scene up there as they recover and get back on their feet, which we know that they will do. So that's about it, Keith Bilbrey. What's going on with you?
Okay. I'm looking forward to that. I'm really glad that we can go up there and help those folks out. Boy, do they need it. Well, I want to thank the Nashville Jam Company for sponsoring this final segment. These jams are all natural, made right here locally with love. And you notice this same jar has been here for 2 weeks. When Lauderdale's here, it never lasts a week. I'm not pointing any fingers, but it is noticeable. Nashville Jam also available at your local grocer or specialty market. And I want to say hi, give a shout out to our Nashville Jam winner. We have a little chat going on while the show's going on. They give you clues as to what the Nashville Jam song will be. And our guesser tonight is the mom of Clogger, Ordinary Moose. Is that right? Ordinary Moose. Yeah, that's watching since 2012. And favorite band right now is Balsam Range. Well, it's good to have you, Ordinary Moose, amongst us. Once again, has he not done a great job and looked good while doing it in that great suit? It's Peter Cooper. Your shoes could use a little shine, I'm just saying. Hey.
Thank you, Hall of Famer. It is so good to be up here on this stage, even with a Houston Astros fan. It's okay. It's okay. No,
he plays good steel, though.
Well, they got that, like, the little train that run when they hit a home run. The couple times they hit a home run last year, the train
you
goes.
Were there last
it's time. It's good. It's good. We got keyboards and we got mighty pedal steel, and we want to play a Canadian song for you tonight. This is a song that was written by Neil Young. Anybody heard of him? He is a Canadian Americana forerunner. Let's go, guys. We'll do it in A if any of you are playing along. Well, there is a place in North Ontario. Dream, comfort, memory, despair. In my mind, I still need a place to go. All my changes were there.
Blue, blue windows behind the stars. Shadows
tonight from Music City Roots.
Great job, Peter Cooper, everybody. Wonderful night. Music City Roots is a production of Hang Dye Media. The jam continues at Kimbrough's Pickin' Parlor in Franklin. Stop by for a nightcap, a snack, and bring your instruments. We're all going there now for a Blackstone beer and a song or two. I'm Keith Bilbrey, and from the edge of Music City, good night, everybody.